Hey guys, welcome back. Today we are reacting to the Eternals trailer that dropped today. Like always guys, I am not up to date with when these trailers drop, so I'm always behind. Okay? Sorry. I just want to preface by saying I do not know anything about the Eternals. I don't know anything about the comic books. I barely know little hints about the characters. My only equivalent would be the New Gods, which I'm more familiar with, and that's sort of DC's counterpart. But I know that the Eternals and the New Gods have their own differences and their own distinctions, so I don't want to compare the two. I feel like it's kind of unfair. I am familiar with the Inhumans. And I feel like they have more similarities between the Inhumans and the Eternals, but like I said, I do not know. So whatever happens in this trailer, it's all a surprise to me. I won't have much to comment in terms of linking that to Marvel Comics. So bear that in mind, I am just excited to see this. I love the director, I love the actors, the cast is crazy. So I'm just excited to see this movie. I am excited to just see it as a movie, not really a comic book movie. So there, I just wanted to say that. So please don't write down in the comments you don't know anything about the comics, because you would just be stating a fact. So let's go. This is beautiful. My God. This is like a rival.
It's beautiful. Listen.
This feels so different.
We have watched. Unguided. We have helped them progress. And seen them accomplish wonders. Throughout the years, we have never interfered. Until
wow. This looks...
Thank you for this.
Oh, you're welcome.
So now that Captain Rogers and Iron Man are both gone, who do you think's gonna lead the Avengers?
I could lead them.
Wow. I'm beyond impressed. But like, what can I say? It's Chloe Zhao. This movie feels so Chloe Zhao, and I don't know if you guys saw the Marvel MCU Phase 4 trailer reaction or whatever discussion that I did with myself. But I was like, this feels like a very different approach to a Marvel movie, which most Marvel movies are. Obviously, we get our standard run-of-the-mill sort of, oh, okay, they're following sort of that structure, the same kind of color palette, they're following the same kind of humor, and you can kind of watch these movies and be like, all right, I kind of see how the director put their stamp on it, but it really does feel like it came out of the Marvel machine, sort of like Ant-Man and the Wasp, basically the Ant-Man movies, Thor the Dark World, like movies like that, where it's just kind of generic and it feels like, and like it doesn't really leave a lasting impact. This movie, on the other hand, feels like it's totally Chloe Zhao's, except that little sting at the end of the trailer, which is sort of like them saying, hey, this is a Marvel movie, this is connected. And obviously the Avengers and Marvel or whatever, all the other characters are going to play a part in this. And the Eternals are literally what they are. They are these eternal beings that have been guiding humanity and sort of helping them out in their time of need, being quiet, staying in the shadows, sort of like an intergalactic Red Cross. That's sort of what I'm getting off of this. We saw one character with the ability to create water, and that's just, yeah, that's very handy. We could use that. We see that they all have their own unique abilities, and we get to see Angelina Jolie, and we get to see Richard Madden, and Kumail, and Salma Hayek, and me just saying this cast, Barry Keoghan, it's crazy. This cast is insane, and we finally got to see Kit Harington in this, and I will scroll through the trailer and kind of touch on the things that I really liked, but just overall, this trailer feels tonally so Chloe Zhao's. It looks incredibly beautiful. The shots feel reminiscent of Terrence Malick with like a blend of Arrival, kind of like a Denis Villeneuve, and I don't know, it just feels very unique. It feels like nothing that Marvel's done before, and I know people say that about every single Marvel movie, but this really does feel like it is deriving off that sort of palette, that sort of look that Marvel movies have. It definitely feels like one of the most beautiful Marvel movies that we've had, and not because there's unique and gorgeous looking set pieces or anything like that, which we do have in the trailer, but it just looks like a very beautifully shot movie, if that makes sense. It's not necessarily where they are, but it's how it's shot. That's what I'm saying. So I really love this. I've heard Kevin Feige say that this is a movie that could be deserving of an Oscar, and I know that's sort of like the highest regard you can give a movie, but you know, people aren't really tuning into the Oscars anymore, so what does that really mean anymore? Who knows? But the fact that Kevin Feige is saying that, I guess that's a really high praise for the movie. But overall, that aside, I just want to see how good this is. I don't care about its ties to the comics. I know some people who might be Eternals comics fans might really be hoping for things in the comics to show up in this movie. But for me, I'm completely fine just going in blind. This looks interesting. This looks fascinating. Those are words that mean the same thing. This looks like a very unique family film as well, as you guys can see at the end of the trailer. And I guess this is just gonna be me kind of scrolling through and talking about my favorite bits. But yeah, as we can see here, I wish these little things could go away. But as you can see at the end of the trailer, they're having their sort of like Thanksgiving and their family gathering or whatever, just because they are ageless beings, and who else can they really relate with other than each other? So this is a really cool moment. I can't see everyone here because great, we have these two thumbnails blocking the way. But as you can see up here, we have Ma Dong-seok. Oh my God, my mom is going to roast my pronunciation. I'm so sorry. And then we have Richard Madden, we have Angelina Jolie. She sort of looks like she's leading the group, even though I hear that Salma Hayek's character is sort of the leader, at least her character is in the comics. Again, I do not know, so correct me as you will. But yeah, this is great. I love this vibe that it's giving off. It feels like they are in, I don't know, colonial times. I can't really place where they are right now, but apparently they have been guiding humanity on Earth. So these beings have been living amongst us, and they've been, like I said, they've been helping out. So whatever this is going to be, it's going to be several period pieces all in one movie, which is just another reason to go watch this movie. It's doing something unique. It's doing something different. I'd love to see how these people, these gods, basically, in the relationship to humanity, seeing that maybe be challenged by the fact that maybe they are getting close to certain humans and seeing them die and how that has an impact on their lives. That would be really interesting. I mean, there's only so much you can do with the amount of characters that they have to balance in this movie. It's sort of like what they were doing with the Avengers, except now they kind of have the confidence. Marvel's kind of like, okay, we've done this before. We've done ensembles. We can do this. And they're just like, all right, here's a bunch of new people you've never seen before. There you go. We don't have any movies establishing who they are. No background for them. This is just, bah, here you go. All right, and I'm completely fine with that. From the looks of it, they look like they're having fun. Cannot wait. So yeah, that's all I have to say about this part here. Oh yeah, obviously you have to talk about Richard Madden. We got the little character here, which is a young girl I was corrected in the last video. She says, who's going to replace Captain Rogers or Steve Rogers for the Avengers? And then we have Richard Madden's character saying, I can do it, which he probably could. he's basically a god. I don't know what his abilities are, but maybe he could. And then everyone kind of giggles and laughs and everyone has a good time. And I thought that was really great. I thought that was fun. They're all kind of like ribbing him. Angelina Jolie kind of gives a smirk later on because she's probably like, I could probably do that shit. I can lead the Avengers. Easy. But I won't say anything. So that's kind of the vibe I'm getting. I'm really just digging in deep into whatever they're giving me. So let's see. Oh, this shot is... There we go. That's the whole ensemble right there. Comments about their costumes. I know that people are going to say they're not loyal to the comic books, but I know that Marvel has sort of a track record of being loyal, pretty loyal to the comic books counterparts, while also adding some realistic touches. And I think this is perfectly fine. I don't think people are too married to the characters of the Eternals where they can't see someone kind of take inspiration from other cultures and kind of blend that into their costumes. And I feel like that's kind of what they're doing. I think Salma Hayek's character is somewhat reminiscent of her comic book counterpart, but I can't speak to that. I've seen one image and I'm like, okay, they kind of got some things with the headdress and things like that. So whatever. But overall, they kind of look sort of like generic costumes with blends of unique colors so that we can differentiate the characters. And I think that's all we need. Man, it's awesome seeing them all together. We have Brian Tyree Henry, which is a guy that I am just super excited about because I love that actor. He's so good in Atlanta. He's good in everything. He was great in Child's Play, too. That's all I got to say about this. Pretty cool. Moving on. Oh, yeah, Barry Keoghan. That kid is incredible. Everything he's in, he just knocks it out of the park. So really excited for him. Let's see. Okay, so we get first appearance of Kit Harington and Gemma Chan. Not first appearance of Gemma Chan. She's been in the previous teaser. But we get Kit Harington, and he's going to be playing Black Knight. Right now, he just kind of looks like he works at a library in Bristol. But, yeah, that's all we really get to see. We don't really get to see him in his Black Knight garb, but we'll see that in the movie, and I'm glad that they left it out. Let's keep going. That was cool. Yes, so we get this sort of Bollywood-esque sequence here, and we get to see Kumail. Yeah, right here. So we get to see Kumail and sort of leading this dance, and I can't wait for that. The fact that they're doing just so many interesting things with this, the fact that they're blending so many different cultural influences in cinema into one, it's so cool. Like, the fact that we get sort of a Bollywood sequence in a Marvel movie, guys, that's cool, okay? Say what you want about the Disney machine and Marvel, but the fact that we're getting this in a comic book movie, I mean, when like 20 years ago we got Blade and we were just so thankful that we got Blade, we have come so far. I watched Blade recently. It does not hold up for me personally, but I see its charm. I see where it's fun. Wesley Snipes is great, but we have come so far as comic book fans. The movies that we're getting, it's just, we don't deserve it, guys. And this is just another reason why. This is awesome. I cannot wait. Dude, look at the definition on his delts. His arms are crazy, man. I'm trying to get there. Okay, let's move on. So, yeah, we get to see them use their abilities. I don't really want to talk about that because I don't know what's happening here. Seance, this right here. So this timeless love, I assume, you know, that looks like they're about to kiss. So I don't have to spell that out for you guys. But this sequence right here, this cut between different either time periods or different locations, it's beautiful. I love that. I love seeing that. So it kind of gives out the idea that this is a timeless love, and sort of reminds me of the old guard, that couple, in there where it's just like they've been with each other for so long. It's like, I thought that was such an interesting angle about that movie, and I hope that kind of carries that over here. Like, what do you do in a relationship where you've known each other for hundreds of thousands of years, probably. So that's really interesting to see. Cannot wait to see that. What else do we got? So this shot, like I said, was very reminiscent of Arrival, but I guess you could say that about any alien encounter film. But this shot was just really cool. It's just kind of like this obelisk, this thing just coming towards them during what appears to be the Stone Age. And so I guess this is them finally arriving on Earth, and this is going to be sort of where they become the gods of that time, and they'll probably become legends, just living amongst us, kind of blending into society, because I assume that they help humanity up to this point. moving forward and, yeah, basically just restructuring and giving everyone the resources and technology to kind of move forward. So yeah, that's going to be really cool. But I thought this shot was really interesting and looked very unique. It's very different than sort of that first encounter you see of a spaceship in Marvel movies. Like, the last one I can think of is when Peter Quill gets taken up. It's like, put those side by side, and it's like this, it's completely different vibe that we're getting from those two shots. That's again me just reading way too much into it, and it probably doesn't make sense to anyone else but me. But yeah, this is great here. And yeah, we get to see them kind of looking out. The shot again just kind of reminds me of Arrival, that room where Amy Adams is looking at the alien. It's just this big huge window or monitor just looking out. Like I said, it doesn't make any sense to anyone but me, but yeah, that's where my mind goes to. Yeah, I don't know, man, just the use of light and shadow so far in this trailer, it just looks really, really pretty. It's a pretty looking movie. That's all I can say about that. Let's see, so we get to see Angelina Jolie, just flawless, looking great. But yeah, this shot here, I don't want to speak for where this would be. I feel like I'm so uneducated, but is this like the Byzantine Empire or something? Is this even Earth? I assume it is. Is this a structure that exists on Earth and I am just so uneducated that I don't know what it is? Is this the Roman Empire? Where is this? I want to say it's the Byzantine Empire, or I don't know. I don't want to speak to it. I sound dumb. I sound dumb, and hearing my own voice trying to guess just makes me feel dumber. And Barry Keoghan, I don't know, some vibes about this guy. Anytime I see him in a movie, I'm like, this guy's up to no good, because he's so good at playing just someone who's sort of unsettling, kind of like a Paul Dano. Yeah, just love this actor, and I don't know, just something about him. Yeah, all the Yorgos Lanthimos movies, or just one of them specifically, I can't think of the name right now, but he was in it, and he scared the crap out of me. So yeah, that's it. Maybe it's just his face. Maybe he has a resting scary face. That's it. That's really all I have to say scrubbing through this trailer. I mean, I covered basically everything I want to talk about, and it is a tease. They don't show too much. They don't reveal too much. I'm sure most of the people tuning in to watch this trailer were hoping that they would, you know, allude to different characters, which they did. They gave us that little thing at the end, and that's really all we need. But I think that this movie should be able to stand on its own without the Marvel Universe, without the other characters, and I would be completely fine with that, because this feels different, and I'm so glad that they're still doing things that feel new and fresh, even 10 plus years into this game. So yeah, that's all I have to say, guys. I'm really excited. November cannot come sooner enough, but man, guys, it's already towards the end of May. That's crazy. Like, yeah, we are almost halfway through 2021. Time moves fast, guys. Hug your loved ones. I hope you're staying safe, vaccinated, etc. But yeah, hope you're healthy, wealthy, wise, happy with life. And yeah, guys, are you guys excited? Let me know down in the comments below. What did I miss? I missed a lot. What did I completely just butcher? Like, let me know in the comments down below, please. And anyways, guys, thank you guys so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Like, comment, yada, yada, yada. Do what you want. And yeah, as always, guys, I will see you later.